As you look at this photo of the winter night sky, are you able to point out all the different constellations? And if so, how are you able to figure this out? For me, I use Orion as a guide to help me figure out all the other constellations in the winter sky. But there are other patterns besides constellations in the night sky, and these are known as asterisms. There are two famous asterisms in the winter sky, such as the winter triangle and then the winter hexagon. And in this video, we're going to explore the similarities and differences between these two star patterns. Welcome to Learn the Sky. My name is Janine, and I'll be your guide as we explore the night sky together, one constellation at a time. Before we dive into the differences between the winter triangle and winter hexagon, let's first review what an asterism is. So an asterism is a pattern of stars that can make up part of a constellation, or it can connect a few bright stars that makes its own unique pattern. And they're often used as a guide to other stars. So in this video, we're going to focus on the winter triangle and the winter hexagon. Both of them are asterisms. The winter triangle, as you can probably guess, is made up of a pattern of three stars, and it connects the constellation known as Orion, Canis Major, and Canis Minor. You can also notice that it makes an equilateral triangle shape, so that makes it easy to point out in the sky. And these three stars are the brightest ones within the winter sky. So even if you live in an area with lots of light pollution, you still should be able to point out these three stars in the night sky, and then you would use them to help you find other constellations. The winter hexagon is, again, very similar, but it's just a bigger star pattern. It connects six bright stars instead of three, and those stars include Sirius, Procyon, Pollux, which is in Gemini, Capella, which is in Auriga, you have Aldebaran, which is in Taurus. So let's get some practice with how to identify both the winter triangle and the hexagon. So looking at this original photo, which we've seen this before in the very beginning, if you can start to find the winter triangle, that is a very good start. And this is a very ideal picture that you would have here. We don't always necessarily have really great dark skies like this in order for us to see all these constellations, but it's a good picture to practice with. So here is where the winter triangle is. Notice it connects Orion, Canis Major, and Canis Minor. But the winter hexagon is much bigger. It covers the area with six different constellations instead of only three. And if we were to superimpose these on each other, you can see that the triangle sits within the hexagon. So why do we even care about this at all? Because we can use these star patterns to help us find other constellations in the sky. So first, we start with a clean slate, and the first thing that my eye is drawn to is Orion. From there, if I can find Orion, I use the shoulder of the giant to connect the three stars right there, which is the winter triangle. And these are the constellations it connects. And there is our winter triangle. Another fun fact about the winter triangle is that the constellation Monoceros is right in the center of the winter triangle. It is a very faint constellation, and Monoceros is represented as a unicorn. I have a whole video on that, so be sure to go check it out. But from there, you can start to work your way around the sky, starting at the winter triangle. Now we're gonna move into the winter hexagon, because here's where Gemini is. Then we have Auriga, and then Taurus right here. And it really is these six constellations right here that we can connect the brightest stars of them to make that hexagon pattern. There's also Lepus down here. That's a cute little constellation represented as a hare. So use this information to help you find both the winter triangle and the winter hexagon. They are fairly easy to point out. I would say the triangle is easiest to point out, and when you get really comfortable using the triangle to find all the other constellations, you can graduate to finding the winter hexagon. In the next portion of this video, I'm going to use a Venn diagram to make a comparison of both of these objects in the sky. I do this with all of my versus videos. So first, we'll start with the things that are similar. Both the winter triangle and the winter hexagon, they are both asterisms. They're not true constellations, but patterns we can use to help us find the constellations. They're both seen in the wintertime for the northern hemisphere, and they both have two stars, Sirius and Procyon, that are both a part of these. But then we start to differ. So the winter triangle is only made of three stars, Sirius, Betelgeuse, and Procyon, and it is smaller in size. I recommend that when you're looking for these objects, start with the winter triangle and then try to find the bigger winter hexagon. The winter hexagon is made up of six stars, Sirius, Procyon, Pollux, Capella, Aldebaran, and Rigel. It does take up more real estate in the sky, so it is definitely larger in size. In fact, the winter triangle is within the larger winter hexagon. And I've also found some other names for the winter hexagon. I've heard it called the winter circle or the winter oval. So I hope this video was helpful for you to find the differences between the winter triangle and the winter hexagon. They both have similar purposes. It's just a matter of, are you able to see them? For me, I think the triangle is easier because sometimes I just don't have a wider view of the entire sky to actually see the entire hexagon. It just kind of depends on where I'm viewing from and what time of night I'm going out at. But they are similar that they're both asterisms. We can see them from December through March, and they have these two stars in common. However, their shape, size, and number of stars is different. So I encourage you to go outside, try to find these asterisms, and use them to help you find all the constellations in the winter sky. It really is a brilliant time to go outside and see the stars, even if it may be cold for you. So remember, anytime that you go outside, you have to take time to just observe. It takes time, patience, and practice, and persistence as well. So I wish you luck, and as always, keep looking up.